This conference will now be recorded.
Hey, good morning all. We will continue the personality disorders, and I am Prashant, Assistant Professor of Psychiatry. Hope you remember all these disorders which we discussed earlier. I'll go through it briefly. Coming to the DSM classification of DSM-5 classification of personality disorders. These include cluster A, B, and C. And cluster A share the features of odd and aloof features, and which includes schizotypal, schizoid, and paranoid. And cluster B share the features like dramatic, impulsive, and erratic. And these include narcissistic, borderline, and antisocial and histrionic personality disorders. And coming to the cluster C, these share like anxious and fearful features. These include obsessive compulsive, dependent, and avoidant features, avoidant personality disorder. And does anyone remember last time we covered what all the personality disorders? Does anyone remember? Because I forgot. Pawan?
Sir?
Do you remember last time entire cover chesanu? Histrionic aipoyindi kada, we completed histrionic, right? Any idea?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Pardon?
Completed sir.
Okay, fine. We'll start from the narcissistic. Coming to the narcissistic personality disorders, it is a long-term pattern of abnormal behavior characterized by the exaggerated feelings of self-importance and excessive need for admiration and lack of understanding of other feelings. Maybe you can see these people in your batch at times, and people affected by it often spend a lot of time thinking about achieving power or success or about their appearance. They often take advantage of people around them. The behavior typically begins by early adulthood and occurs across a variety of situations. The whole concept lies in me, whatever it is. And underneath their self-esteem, it is a fragile and sensitive to criticism. And 5 to 6% of general population are affected because of this personality disorder. Coming to the diagnosis, according to DSM-5, a pervasive pattern of grandiosity, that is in fantasy or behavior, need for admiration, lack of empathy towards others, and beginning in early adulthood and present in a variety of contexts, as indicated in the five of the following, has a grandiose sense of self-importance, preoccupied with fantasies, power, and beauty. He or she is special and can be understood only by or should associate with other special or high status people or institutions. And they require excessive admiration and has a sense of entitlement, unreasonable expectations of especially favorable treatment. And coming to the, they are interpersonally exploitative and lacks empathy, that is unwillingness to recognize or identify the feelings and needs of others, and is often envious of others or feels that others are envious on him, and they are arrogant at times. Theodor classification of a narcissistic personality disorder is, they are unprincipled narcissist, that is includes antisocial behavior, amorous narcissist includes histrionic traits, compensatory narcissist includes negativistic and avoidant features, and elitist narcissist pure type, malignant narcissism includes sadistic, paranoid, and antisocial features. Committing the clinical features, as I said, they have grandiose sense of self-importance, consider themselves special and expect special treatment always, handle criticism poorly, get engaged when some people criticize them, or they appear completely indifferent to criticism, are ambitious and strive for fame and fortune, struggle with relationships, interpersonal exploitativeness is common, cannot show empathy towards others. Due to their susceptible for self-esteem, they are prone for depression, interpersonal difficulties, occupational problems, rejection, and loss are among the stresses commonly produced by their behavior, which they are at least able to handle. Denial is the most common defense mechanism used by them. Committing the course and prognosis. It is chronic and difficult to treat. Aging is handled poorly. And onset is as usual childhood or adulthood. And have more midlife crisis. Treatment. Narcissistic personality disorder is rarely the primary reason for people seeking mental health treatment. When people with narcissistic personality disorder enter treatment, it is typically prompted by life difficulties or to seek relief from another disorder, such as major depressive disorder, substance use disorders, bipolar disorder, or eating disorders, or at the insistence of relatives and friends. This is partly because of individuals with narcissistic personality disorders generally have poor insight and fail to recognize their perception and behavior as inappropriate and problematic due to their very positive self-image. And the treatment lies mainly on the psychotherapy, and contemporary treatment modalities commonly involve transference focused and metacognitive and the schema for focused therapies. You can't understand these metacognitive and schematic focused therapies because the psychotherapies will be covered in the later session. So at least note down these main points. And another type of treatment would be temperament change. And we have to address if they have any, like, you know, as I said earlier, depression or drug addiction, or okay, we have to treat them also accordingly. And psychoanalytic psychotherapy may be effective in treating narcissistic personality disorder, but therapists must recognize that the patient traits and use caution in tearing down narcissistic defenses to do quickly. Anger, rage, impulsivity, and impatience can be worked on with still training. Group treatment has its benefits. Relationship therapy stresses the importance of learning and applying four basic interpersonal skills: affective expression, empathy, discussion, and problem solving, conflict resolution. Marital and relation therapy is the most beneficial when both partners participate. Pharmacotherapy is useful when the comorbid substance abuse, eating disorders, depression, as I said earlier. In one word, a narcissistic would rather impress a stranger than be loved by his own family. Coming to the avoided cluster C, avoided personality disorder, it shows extreme sensitivity to rejection and may lead socially withdrawn lives. They are not asocial and seek companionship, but they fail as they mostly need unusually strong guarantees of uncritical acceptance, tend to have an inferiority complex. It is a mental condition that is characterized by the feelings of inadequacy, extreme shyness, and sensitivity to rejection. The main thing, the main underlying feature in the avoidant personality disorder is sensitivity to rejection. They feel that they may be rejected if they talk to a new person. They think that maybe I may be rejected. So they will be like extreme shy to initiate a conversation. Epidemiology, it is around 2 to 3% of general population, equal among both sexes. According to DSM-5, the criteria is avoid occupational activity that involves significant interpersonal contact because of fear of criticism and disapproval of rejection. As I said earlier, unwilling to mix with people unless sure about being liked. So they maintain friendship only with the people who can guarantee them that they don't criticize him or her. Restrained in intimate relationships because of fear of being shamed or ridiculed. Preoccupied with being criticized or rejected in social situations. Views oneself as inferior to others. Reluctant to engage in new activities because they may prove embarrassing. Clinical features. Usually they are timid, and hypersensitivity to rejection is a central feature. As I said, desire warmth and security of human relations, but just their justification of not being in a relationship is that they are afraid of rejection, and they have lack of self-confidence. As they are afraid of rejection, they avoid public speaking and making requests to others. Refusal of any request make them feel hurt and make them withdrawn. They generally take jobs on the sidelines. They rarely attain much personal advancement or exercise much authority, but they are shy and love to please. Less close friends are confidence as they are afraid of rejection. Course and prognosis. able to perform normally in a protected environment only, and if support system fails, example family, they are subject to depression and anxiety, anger. Phobias, especially strong, especially social phobia, are common comorbidities. Treatment is establishing rapport is very important. Fear of rejection should be addressed. Then the patient should be told to go out into the world to take what are perceived as a great risk for humiliation and rejection. However, one should be careful as a failure can reinforce the patient's already low self-esteem. Group therapy is helpful. Pharmacotherapy is used when the comorbid anxiety or depression is present. Beta blockers can be used to counter the autonomic overactivities like when they feel like palpitations, anxiousness, or sweating in the hands, tremors. This is the picture of avoidant personality disorder. Sorry, dependent. Coming to the dependent, subordinate their own needs to those of others. Get others to assume responsibility about major areas of their life. Lack self-confidence and not able to stay along for the long periods of time. Coming to the epidemiology, it is more seen in the women. 2.5% of personality disorders cases fall under this category. More common in young children than in the adults. Person with chronic physical illness in childhood are more prone for it. Coming to the DSM-5 criteria for the dependent, has difficulty in making everyday decisions without an excessive amount of advice or reassurance from others. It's like even for the ordering the food which he or she likes, they depend upon others to decide what they want, and needs others to assume responsibility for the most major areas of their life. Has difficulty expressing disagreement with others due to fear of rejection. Has difficulty doing things on their own. Can go to excessive lengths to get support from others. Feels uncomfortable or helpless when left alone. Urgently seeks other relationships to get care when a relationship ends. Clinical features. Coming to the behavior, they are submissive and dependent. Not able to make their own decisions. Depends upon others to make them. Avoids positions of responsibility and become anxious if asked to assume a leadership role. They prefer to be submissive. Given tasks, they find it easy to perform in the company of others. Their relationships are distorted by their need to be attached with another person, as they do not like to be alone and seek out others on whom they can depend. Pessimism, self-doubt, passivity, and fears of expressing sexual and aggressive feelings are characteristics of them. They will tolerate their alcoholic, unfaithful spouse for long periods as they fear to be left alone. Differential diagnosis. Dependent states are found in the most psychiatric disorders, thus differentiating it is difficult. Dependency is central feature of histrionic and borderline. But the differentiating feature is that they stay in relationship for long duration and are not manipulative. But coming to the borderline or histrionic, especially borderline, they maintain a very short duration with a relationship, and they will skip onto the other relationship. But here, they maintain a long-lasting relationship because they are dependent on them. They can't live without the dependent other. Dependent personality disorder can occur in persons with agoraphobia, but those cases, panic attack feature will be there. Course and prognosis. Course is not clearly known. Occupational functioning is impaired. Social relations are limited to those on whom they can depend. If relationships do not end, well, they are more prone to major depressive disorders. Psychotherapy. Outcome is good with the psychotherapy. Insight-oriented psychotherapy are particularly helpful. Behavioral therapy, group and family therapy are also helpful. A pitfall may arise when the therapist tries to change the dynamics of the pathological relationship, and this should be avoided no matter how much pathological the relationship may seem. Coming to the pharmacotherapy, it is used to treat when symptoms of depression and anxiety are present. To treat psychomotor retardation of depression, psychostimulants can be used. Benzodiazepines can be used if they have sleeping difficulties. And the non-benzodiazepine anxiolytics can be used to promote sleep if insomnia is desired. SSRIs have the choice of drug for the depression. See, every personality disorder, like before going to disorder, everyone have the traits, even the dependent trait, even the histrionic trait, even the borderline traits. Trait is nothing but a characteristic. Okay, every individual of like everyone will have traits like OCD traits, borderline traits. But whenever these traits cross the threshold line, okay, threshold. When these cross the threshold, they land up in the disorder. What is disorder? It's nothing but they are having difficulties with the social occupational well-being. Okay, when these disease characteristics disturbs their social or occupational platforms, they land up in the disorder. But traits are normal. Okay, even everyone. Okay, everyone will having the traits. Okay, trait having the traits is normal. Coming to the obsessive compulsive personality disorder, it is not obsessive compulsive disorder. It is obsessive compulsive personality disorders. Okay. In these personality disorder, everyone have so for like a person is having obsessions about being hygiene. It is a trait. Okay. It is a good feature up to some extent because, for example, it protects from many harmful diseases. Like this is a pandemic. Okay. We have to sanitize our hands, we have to keep mask, and we have to maintain self-hygiene. Okay, it is a healthy feature. But this healthy feature, if they cross the threshold, like without a meaning, if he is having hygienic obsessions, these may land in a disorder type. Okay, these are characterized by the emotional constriction, orderliness, perseverance, stubbornness, indecisiveness, perfectionism, and inflexibility. Epidemiology 2 to 8% in general population and more in men. Genetic pattern of inheritance present more. So in first degree relatives, it is present. Mostly seen in people who are brought up in a harsh disciplined conditions. According to Freud, the disorder is associated with difficulties in the anal stage of psychosexual development. Coming to the DSM-5 classification. It is a preoccupation with details, rules, order, or schedules to the extent that major point of activity is lost. Perfectionism and interference with the task completion. Too much involved in work and avoids leisure activity for friends. Overconscious and inflexible about matters of morality, ethics, or values, and hoarding. What is hoarding? Can anyone say? Pawan.
Sir, keeping all the materials like whatever they want, they are obsessed about, they keep all these things in their trash or something like that.
To some extent, keeping or saving all the materials which doesn't have any use at all. Okay.
Use, yes.
For example, saving the 500 rupees note after even after the demonetization, is it useful? No, but like those things are saving the things like wallets, pens, or which are not useful at all. Saving those things, they think that they might be useful in the future, but they are illogical. Okay, this is called hoarding. And coming to the classification, they are rigidity and stubbornness. They have the clinical features, preoccupation with rules, regulations, and orderliness, details, and achievement of perfectionism. They follow rules rigidly. Okay, lack flexibility and are intolerant. Capable of prolonged work provided it is routinized and changes are not made. Interpersonal skills are less and lack of sense of humor. Unable to compromise and insist others submit to their needs. They try to please whom are more powerful than them. They are fearful about committing a mistake, so they are indecisive and ruminate about making decisions. They have less friends because they are less flexible, and they anything which tries to disrupt their routine provokes much anxiety in them. Differential diagnosis, as I said, OCD, it is obsessive compulsive disorder. Okay, it is different from the obsessive compulsive personality disorder because obsessive compulsive personality disorder is like, okay, it will be onset occurs around in teenage, like engaged like 13 or 14. And the main thing is they have personality traits. Okay. When they cross the threshold, they land up in the disorder. Even us have some of them have personality traits like having following rules, being punctual, completing the work and today itself. Okay. It is difficult to distinguish someone with the OC traits and someone with the OCPD. Sometimes delusional disorder may coexist. Course and prognosis, it is variable and unpredictable. May develop obsessions or compulsions from time to time. What is compulsion? Anyone?
It is the act they do repeatedly.
Sorry?
Actions which they do repeatedly.
Yeah, why do they act like that?
Because of
if you touch an object, you feel like maybe, for example, in this pandemic situation, maybe there is a virus. Okay. If you get these thoughts repeatedly, okay, this is called obsession. And because of getting these repeatedly thoughts, you tend to wash your hands again and again, again and again. Okay. This is called act or compulsion. Okay. In order to avoid those obsessive thoughts, we will do an act in order to calm ourselves. This is compulsion. Okay. Some may develop schizophrenia in future or major depressive disorder. Flourish in work settings where there is methodical, deductive, detailed work, but vulnerable to unexpected changes. Treatment is psychotherapy. Unlike others, people with OCPD are aware and often seek treatment alone. It is means they have insight on their own problem. Okay. Group therapy and behavior therapy is helpful. Distraction strategies, relaxation techniques, biofeedback are useful, and yoga is beneficial. Rewarding in group therapy is following change you positive reinforcement. Coming to the pharmacotherapy, clonazepam is used to reduce anxiety, and clomipramine, it is a first drug approved for the treatment of obsessive compulsive disorder, and SSRIs selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors particularly useful to break through the obsessions and compulsions. Antidepressants and antipsychotics uses a reserved based on the need. Like if they have delusions or psychotic symptoms, we can be used on the we can be used antipsychotics. Personality change due to general medical conditions, it is very common, and it is related to personality change which happens after disease and which was not the nature of the not the nature of the person. Example, post concussional syndrome or post stroke. Coming to the etiology, common ones are head trauma, cerebral vascular diseases, cerebral traumas, tumors, epilepsy, Huntington's disease, and endocrine disorders, heavy metal poisoning, example, mercury, neurosyphilis, and AIDS. Diagnosis and clinical features, change in personality from previous pattern of behavior or exacerbation of previous personality, unable to control impulse or emotions, emotional liability present, temper outburst without provocation is present, violent behavior, impulsive activity can be the in the form of making inappropriate jokes, sexual advances or antisocial activity, and shoplifting. If temporal lobe epilepsy is present, then the presentation is like humorless, hyperphagia, and marked aggressiveness during the shear. Cognitive impairment can be seen. Concentration is ill-sustained, thus recent memory can be affected. To confirm the diagnosis, the symptoms should not be due to the other medical condition and should be abrupt. Differential diagnosis, dementia, other psychiatric conditions where personality change may occur is schizophrenia, delusional disorder, mood disorders, impulse control disorders. Coming to the course and prognosis, depends upon the underlying medical cause. If due to damage to the structure of brain, then the disease tends to stay for a long time. Can be produced by intoxication or drug therapy, which can be easily reversed. Can progress into the dementia in few cases. Treatment, treat the underlying general medical condition is the pivotal role. Psychiatric medicines like are needed if the underlying depression or any other psychiatric comorbidity present. Alcohol should be avoided. Counseling and family support important. Generalized approach to personality disorder patients. Stages in the development of self-awareness and well-being. These are unaware, okay. First stage, one, average adult cognition, two, metacognition, and three, contemplation. Unaware. Absence of self-awareness occurs in several personality disorders. There is a little or no insightful awareness. Lacking awareness, people act on their immediate likes and dislikes, which is described as an immature or childlike ego state. Average adult cognition. This is purposeful but egocentric, able to delay gratification, have frequent negative emotions, example anxiety, anger, disgust, which is described as the adult ego stage. Coming to metacognition, described as the parental ego stage. They are mature. They can delay their gratification and aware of own subconscious thinking, calm and patient, and able to supervise conflicts and relationships. Coming to the contemplation, it is very calm, impartial awareness, wise, creative, and loving, able to access what was previously unconscious as needed without effort or distress, described as a state of well-being or soulfulness. Barriers in effective treatment of personality disorders. There are three main barriers. Loss of professional objectivity signaled by the development of strong emotions and is called countertransference. The second preventable error is to believe the personality disorder can't be treated. Okay. The third preventable error is to give direct advice or personal and social problems. Stages in the treatment of personality disorders. This is the crisis management. This is the first step. Crisis management and stabilization of patient. Awakening of positive perspective and personal value in life. Other-centered awareness and integrated intelligence. Stabilization depends upon particular patient. It can be achieved through medication. Like anxiety, if they have anxiety, giving SSRIs or beta blockers, depression, treating the depression with SSRIs, emotional liability, like with the lithium or olanzapine, which are mood stabilizers, and affective aggression, like lithium and SSRIs, predatory aggression, atypical neuroleptics, which are antipsychotics, organic like aggression, tricyclic antidepressants, asociality, like, okay, it is particular to the patient and particular to the condition. After stabilization of patient, awakening a positive perspective. It is positive approaches are letting go of struggles, accept the responsibility, and avoid violence for fights. Working in service of others, do acts of kindness and don't be possessive. Growing in awareness, listen to the heart and don't criticize others. Understanding the thought process, be calm and try to justify everything based on the intellect. Coming to the other-centered, mood dysregulation, example, feeling like victim or feeling separate. They have character goals should be trust and self-respect. Aggression, if they have aggression and impulsivity, impulse control and self-mastery should be obtained. And if they have social dysregulation, we have to treat how to be empathetic. In this patient is basically taught about the problem causes of symptoms. These are the scales for the personality disorders. If you are interested, you can write down these scales. We use Wisconsin Personality Disorder Inventory in the OPD. Thank you. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you.